Hi, I'm Sophie Williams. You're watching NME and we're at Reading Festival with the lovely Holly Humberstone. Hey Holly, how are you?
Hey, I'm really good, thank you. I'm excited to be here.
So this year kind of marks your first proper run of festival shows. What's that experience been like for you so far?
It's been amazing, like very, very intense. I think I'm still, it's the end of summer now and I'm at the end of the cycle, but I feel like I'm still just kind of getting used to it and adjusting and stuff, but I feel like I'm making up for lost time and just taking every minute I can get at a festival. Mm-hmm. Taking it all in, and I'm loving it. I feel really grateful that we can all enjoy live music again. It's sick.
Love that. And growing up, did you ever attend Reading or Leeds Festival?
I did actually. Leeds Festival, I grew up in Grantham, so it's kind of near Nottingham and it's like a little bit further north. So everyone from school would, at the end of school, would kind of just like pile on the train together and go to Leeds Festival. So that was just so like mad and chaotic, but really fun. So many good memories, and it's just really cool to be playing. I played my set at Leeds the other day and it was just really nice to see people from school in the crowd for some reason. It was just like
bit of a mad full circle moment there for you, right?
Exactly, quite comforting to see some girls from school. But yeah,
it's been a bit crazy for you as well, because obviously your career has really taken off throughout the pandemic when we've all been super isolated, haven't been able to be at events like this. What's it been like coming out of that and suddenly emerge into a huge fan base and loads of festival booking, has that been quite daunting?
Yeah, it has. I mean, like, it occurred to me really recently that, well, basically my first song came out like a month before we actually locked down. And then I've released an EP and a half since then, over lockdown. So it occurred to me recently that I'd never actually seen like any physical proof of these people existing. And like, I'd never had a real chance to meet or thank or like, just see any of these people that are listening to my music. And I think it's all very well seeing statistics online and reading comments and things like that, but like, it's just been really extra special getting out and meeting people and like putting some faces to the names and stuff like that, and getting to just like say thank you, I guess, as well. And
I mean, many of your contemporaries as well, such as Baby Queen and Griff, have sort of been in the same situation. They've come through throughout the pandemic as well. Has that been quite comforting, knowing that you're not the only one going through that?
Yeah, it's been really nice. And I think we've all kind of been inspiring each other kind of throughout the past like kind of year and a half. And yeah, it's just been lovely because we've been interacting online and on social media and kind of watching each other's progress and watching each other grow, which has been really nice. And then we finally got to actually meet this summer. I feel like I've already met like a load of these girls, but like, it's just been so lovely to kind of do the festival run almost together and see each other backstage. And yeah, it's just really nice to know that we're kind of all in it together, a little bit of a family. And it's just like, it's lovely. I feel really glad that I've actually managed to make some friends in the industry, because I haven't had a chance to until this summer.
Are there any sort of future collaborations in the pipeline there with some of your friends?
Oh my gosh, maybe.
Maybe.
Like, it would be so lovely. I feel like definitely after seeing each other so much this summer, we're definitely going to have to work together. And I think they're all so amazing and inspiring. So like, for sure, I would be down. Just waiting for them to
just manifest. All the stands will manifest for that.
Exactly.
And speaking of collaboration, actually, so you recently worked with Matty Healy on your recent single, Please Don't Leave Just Yet. Did you work on any other tracks or any other exciting new music bits?
I don't know if I can confirm or deny.
Can you tell us a secret, maybe?
Well, there might be something. I'm working on an album currently. And it's just, I think because Matty and all of these other amazing writers would usually be kind of off around the world doing world tours and being rock stars. But it's been nice. It's been nice because everyone's just kind of had time to collaborate, and everyone's in London, and everyone is just down to work together and make music together. And it's just been so inspiring and just like really, really lovely to work with, you know, some of my biggest inspirations and my biggest kind of influences. So yeah, we've written a couple songs together, so maybe something might be coming out in the future, but
Who knows? Mm-hmm. And how have you found the experience of working on your album so far? That's quite exciting, working on your first sort of full-length body of work.
Yeah. For me, for some reason, like, I think an album is just, like, really daunting. Like, the thought of, like, being done with, like, my debut album and having that much work and releasing that, it's just really, like, final and, like, really scary. So I think it's going to be a while, but I've had, like, loads of time now to just kind of experiment and do all of these different things and try different things out and, like, have fun with writing with no kind of time pressures. And that's been really, really fun, like, over the last few months. So I have loads of music that I'm so excited about. But, yeah, I don't think I'll ever feel like it's finished, and I'll never feel like it's fully done, because I get bored of my work quite quickly. So I think at some point I'll just have to be like, that's it, I'm just putting it out. And then I can forget about it and start on the new thing. But I'm really excited about it. It's scary, but I think it'll be cool.
And what's different about your relationship with Matty compared to previous collaborators as well?
I work a lot with the same people. And I tend to work with people who are artists themselves or have had an artist career. So Rob, who I write a lot with, was in a band called Dog Is Dead, who were quite big around Nottingham when I was growing up at school, and they were really, really cool. And yeah, I work a lot with a guy called Ben Francis Lefwich, who's an amazing artist himself, amazing writer, and Matty, of course. And I think there's a big difference between working with other writers that just write, obviously they're amazing, but I think working with people who, like, bear their heart on their sleeve every day when they come into the studio to write about everything that they're feeling and all of their experiences is, like, so different, because they get it and they understand how it's like. And yeah, I think they can understand that it can be draining as well at times, and we kind of just have to all look after each other. And yeah, it's really nice, and it's just been kind of lovely to build my little team and get a group of people around me that I really trust. And Matty is one of them. People. It's just really nice.
And speaking of Rob, actually, the pair of you debuted a new song at one of your Amira shows the other week, yeah. Room Service. Is that sort of an indication of where you're going with new music in the future?
I guess so. Like, I think that song is, like, the perfect example of, like, the past few weeks and months. We've just had loads of time. The EP's finished, so we've had loads of time to just kind of do whatever we want and write folk songs or write, like, rock Avril Lavigne songs, you know, like we've like covered all of the ground. So it's going to be interesting to see how they all come together as an album and see if they all fit together. But that song I really love because it's just comforting. I wrote that about, it was when we still couldn't see our friends, and I was just missing all my friends, and I just wanted to kind of scoop them up and go and hang out and do stupid stuff, like extra things, like get room service and go day drinking and things like that you just take for granted. So yeah, I think that's why I was kind of missing my friends, and I needed a bit of, like, a hug. So I wrote Room Service, and it's one of my favorites for sure. But yeah, I guess so. Mm-hmm. I don't really think too much about what it sounds like. I pretty much just go with what I feel at the time when I'm writing, and I guess the hard work will come later when I'm trying to figure out how on earth it's all going to fit together and sound coherent. But yeah,
sure. Well, thank you so much for talking to us this afternoon, and enjoy the rest of your Reading Festival.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. I'm excited to be here.